Aku Adli, selamat datang untuk another episode of Korek Fizikal. Hari ini aku ada Sam from Bangface.
Apa khabar?
So macam biasa hari ini aku dengan Sam, kita akan sembang-sembang pasal music, and then kita akan biasa mengurai all the physical releases yang ada dekat Teenage Head Records SS14 Subang Jaya. Ready?
Let's do it.
Okay Sam, what's new?
What's new? Kita mau keluar album. Pop. Something very different. Kita pun tak pernah buat something yang macam tu. Tapi thanks to a producer by the name Easy Musa. Yoke yang actually introduced Easy Musa to me while we wanted to do something different kan. So we cannot really do it ourselves. So we got help, another brain. And then dia sangat-sangat made us different.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I like that different, you know. Sebab saya merasa I look at it as in a long run. Like a set list kan, when we have like fast songs and we have songs like a bit pop, a bit chilled, I think it's good for a set. So macam kita orang pun agree nak buat album tu, but it took us so long. 5 years?
5 years eh?
Yeah, the songs were around for the last 5 years dah ada dah. Just kita orang tak nak keluar benda yang sama. That was always in our head. Kita orang macam something yang lain lah, kita eksperimen lah kan, just a try lah. So pop.
So macam nervous tak masa nak release tu? I mean especially bila consider macam mana orang akan react apa semua.
Well, feedback tu mesti ada lah kan. There's good, there's bad. Ada yang old fans kata macam, korang ni dah legend, mana boleh tukar roots. And then I was like, legend? Benda baru 13 tahun bro. We still as musicians, macam mana cakap, kita kena, we have to be free to experiment kan. But there's loads of stuff out there that we can just ambil ini, pop, make it your own. Call it your own. Don't categorize. Sam dah tak percaya dengan genres dah actually. I don't believe in genre because yelah, kita we're heading to 2020 and then the music is it's changing. The world is changing. Everyone is changing. We have to change.
So other than pop, anything new? Anything else?
Kita orang tengah recording lagu baru.
Uish, pop bukan baru release eh?
Baru release January tapi kita orang, I had also lots of fast songs. Yang macam back to the old thing. I'm sure the fans menanti-nantikan stuff macam ni. Yang kita akan release 99.
Dah nak release lah?
Yes, insyaAllah.
EP, full album?
Just a single dulu.
Okay.
But I have songs lah. And then akan datang album.
Okay, okay. Yeah. So single 99 dah ada tajuk?
Suara. Tajuk dia Suara.
Okay. Looking back, right, macam kau cakap 13 years ago, have you ever thought like macam okay you'll come to this point?
Well, semua band start macam kita rebel, kita just I want to do. But now I think we still have that, but responsibility ada juga, you know. So we need a balance. We need a good balance. Then, but back in those days memang lagi best lah. The scene was lagi meriah. Bands yang kita orang look up to like Hujan, One Buck Short, all these bands yang macam kita orang berlari ikut nak tengok diorang live. I remember One Buck Short, kita orang berlari daripada parking just to see One Buck Short, and I was like, "Per, they inspire us, man." That's why we're trying to do new stuff to inspire again.
I was there masa Situasi.
Betul.
The decision to buat Situasi itu macam mana for a band? Sebab masa korang start dari zaman Blast Off apa semua, it was all English. So apa yang trigger nak jadi ke Situasi itu?
Apparently, lagu Situasi itu asalnya English. Tak ramai tahu lah, tapi I wrote that song in English. And rasanya Pak An dan Yoke lah yang came to me. Cakap, kita Melayu kot. So let's do it. Lambat laun memang Sam nak tulis juga, tapi I wasn't ready kena. Kita punya pronunciation and stuff like that. So Pak An dengan Yoke yang macam lirik banyak daripada orang juga. So lagu tu came out at the right time. It's first lagu Melayu yang tiba-tiba boom. Memang rezeki. So we're very glad orang suka lagu tu. And then it followed up with Revolusi, Extravaganza. The hype dah datang dah dengan satu lagu je. When it went out and then it came, the momentum sampailah sekarang.
So the bahasa yang gunakan tu, you think it's important?
Yes, and then kalau korang perasan, the first word in Situasi is diskriminasi. And to be honest, that was my life. I have a rough childhood. I went through so much, but I shared my stories and apparently orang boleh terima juga. People went through the same thing.
Any shows coming up?
Any shows, Merdeka. Alhamdulillah, lagu kita Puji Malaysia tu is still the lagu kebangsaan for 2019. So, kecing.
Yeah. Ah, cakap macam tu macam mana? I mean like for a punk band, right? Dia tak ada rasa macam konflik ke tak apa. I mean we are, you know.
I believe that is punk. I don't listen to anyone. I only please myself. That's how I think and that's how I just do it. People say Bangface is like that and they know Bangface macam tu. So do we have to remain macam tu? Image, I want to do music sampai insyaAllah if I live long, I want to do music sampai tua bro. 50-60 I see myself singing, man. Okay. Takkanlah malam ni kita punya juga is the song. Orang-orang akan cakap kan, because we can't please everyone, but I try my best.
Bang Fizz is one of the few bands yeah, from that wave tu, 2008 punya wave yang still going on strong. Kau rasa sebab apa?
I think because kita orang tak ada apa-apa lain nak buat tu. You see, we don't have day jobs. Belajar tak pandai. We only know music. So as to survive, kita orang kena juga buat. Naik turun tu biasa lah kan.
Just jalan je. Tak ada
there's no
tak ada macam plan, we
tak
plan.
Tak ada. We don't plan. Everything dia bagi. So just try your best. That's what we do. Kadang-kadang jadi, kadang tak jadi.
So kalau ada tips right, macam for you to share with these new bands, I mean especially in longevity, so what would it be?
Don't be stuck. Macam satu genre ke, or this is my style. Zaman sekarang tak macam tu. Dulu yes macam tu. That's why we have all of these legends here, kan? So all these flavors, dia buat macam-macam music.
Lepas ni kita akan tanya Sam dia punya first album yang dia beli, and then dia punya first musical crush and so much more. Okay Sam, first album kau beli album apa?
Yang terkeja, Raihan.
Serius?
Yes.
Beli?
Beli.
Macam mana boleh
Raihan bro?
Tergerak nak beli Raihan tu?
Rasanya, okay, time tu, okay, I was born in England. Lepas tu umur 4 ke 5 tahun, okay, saya datang sini with my family. And time tu Raihan meletup. As far as I know, dia band yang meletup. So all my cousins memang cerita pasal Raihan je. So that's why I asked my father, beli? That was the first bro.
Serious,
sampai eh? Malaysia, that is the first melody that I heard.
So does it, did it leave an impression to you?
Of course. Ada basic sikit lah.
Okay. Local bands pula yang kau beli?
Disagree.
Album mana?
Album, I think it's the first album. Apa tajuk dia aku lupa, sorry. Tapi it's a really good album. I think that was when Form 2, Form 3. Album 2 and then One Buck Shot pun sama juga. Heavy influenced me. Awal-awal dulu, I was a Michael Jackson freak. Dulu kat UK, because my mother, my mom memang dia bagi makan Michael Jackson je. So that's why I have that. And when I came here, like I said, Raihan. My father pula, 60-an. So setiap kali masuk kereta dengan my dad, A. Ramli, Jeffrey Dane, akan saya makan benda tu. And then when I got to Raja 4 sampai Raja 6 macam tu, my sister pula, boy bands bro. In my house, like crazy, benda tu memang kuat dia buka radio tu kan. So for 2 years, dengar boy bands. And then the punk came right after Form 1, Form 2. Jumpa Pa'an. Kalau tak, dulu Sam nak main bola. Tapi tak dapat. So macam Sam macam kecewa. And the next day, I remember perhimpunan. I saw Pa'an on stage tengah jeng-jeng-jeng dengan senior. Jeng-jeng-jeng macam, poyo Sam Ahmad ni. Aku pun boleh buat macam tu. Macam, and then dah jumpa-jumpa. Then we suddenly talk about music. And then kat situ lah baru masuk Green Day, Sound 41, Good Charlotte, Yellow Card. All these bands that helped me lah. And Sam sangkut dengan muzik macam tu sebab, like I said, dia punya lirik. Dia memang ngam dengan what I've been through. So macam, I want to write this. Semangat punya lagu kan. That's why saya boleh tulis malam ni kita punya. Darah muda. It's because of my influences juga. Positif. I'm a nice guy.
What was the biggest appeal about punk apart from the lyrics?
Time Sam study Green Day. So listening to Green Day, Dookie, banyak gila. And there was one interview, I recognised that Green Day pula, the influence dia by The Clash. So Sam started to masuk to The Clash. And the first thing that I saw was I Fought The Law. Itu the first, Sam turun macam, aku rasa macam sejam lah Sam kat situ, just to figure out why are they fighting the law. Macam best je. So, because we were young kan. And that rebel was inside of us. So, yeah, I listened to The Clash. And then I hopped to the Pistols, Sex Pistols. Tak faham apa-apa diorang sembang sangat. Tapi, I took the image, you know. We took bits and bits in here. Then I made it Bang Fizz.
When you guys first form, memang it has always been Bang Fizz ke?
Dulu, kita orang struggle nak cari nama band. So, macam, dulu ada nama band kita orang Endless. And then, pernah Total Damage.
Total Damage.
Yeah, tapi tak damage mana pun. And then Bang Fizz tu was a Sum 41 song. It was a song called Crazy Amanda Bang Fizz. And time tu kita orang was starting to get shows. Dah start main like prom nights, dah start main Battle of the Bands. Nama band tak ada bro. So macam ambil je lah our old drummer biar. Dia yang kata macam Crazy Amanda Bang Fizz. Ambil Bang Fizz je lah, jalan.
So your first TV exposure was Blast Off. Macam mana tu? The whole experience.
Oh, Blast Off barai bro. I think we memang rezeki kita orang sampai ke situ, to that station. Tapi I think we weren't ready in a way lah. I mean, instrumental kita orang memang belasah je, berapa jadi-jadi ya kan. Tapi that was the journey yang kita orang lalu je. And then after tu, walaupun kita orang tak menang, tetapi there was a guy from Astro yang called us up and said, I want to sponsor you, a free video, a free recording, a single, Silly Lily. So itulah first song yang masuk radio.
The album yang made you wanted to pick up the guitar?
Green Day. Green Day and Sum 41 lah. Because that time, usia tu memang band-band dorang tu yang tengah berkumandang everywhere. And then the vibe pun ngam. I like. Saya suka dia punya aggressiveness. I like the words. I like how they entertain the crowd. Saya suka benda-benda tu.
Your first ever music crush?
Jom Jet.
Jom Jet
maybe. I think because she had that edgy vibe kan. Dia lain time tu and then she's hot.
First gig you went?
I think MCPA Hall. Time tu kita orang datang MCPA tu, kita tak dikenali apa pun. Kita akan bawa CD kita orang. And I remember Sam ada macam satu display tu. So kita akan duduk kat luar koridor tu kan, orang lalu-lalang tu kan. Kita akan bersila kat situ, dengar lagu kita orang kejap. Dengar lagu kita orang, dengar, tak nak beli tak apa, dengar lalu. That's how we started lah. And then hujan akan sampai. Bila hujan sampai macam, oh, semua orang pom naik atas tu. Kita orang macam, apa? Kena jadi macam diorang ni. So benda tu macam, yeah, that was the ni lah. Alhamdulillah sampai lah. 13 tahun kita main muzik, saya tak sangka sebenarnya. Pak An Yoke pun tak sangka.
Okay, kalau orang letak pisau kat leher kan, okay. Ask you to choose. Dalam banyak-banyak Bang Face punya album, wow, which one would be the, you know, the most important?
Album mana kita punya lah.
Why?
Time tu kita orang was going through hard patch lah. I mean, just the band itself lah kan. Kita tak tahu mana nak pergi. And then we were a bit struggling, shows tak ada apa semua kan. So we really sat down and kita orang cakap macam, kita kena tulis lagu yang, you know, really have to be something lah. So tu malam ni kita punya. And then was letak lagu ku with Abang Amy Search. Album tu ada Darah Muda. I like that album. I think it hits people the most. Orang rasa betul Bang Face time tu lah. Feel macam, oh ni Bang Face, ini Bang Face. That's what they say.
So cakap pasal rough patch, there was a time where you had Ascenders.
Yes.
Yang tu macam mana pula?
Okay, time tu asalnya, it was just Sam jumpa Izal from Ombak Shot. Dengan Kudut. Jam, dan kita orang je sembang je after jamming kan. Diorang jamming next. So, let's do a project bro. Something different lah kan. Lepas tu Izal pun memang he fed me all these killers, stuff like that. Very different vibes lah. Dan kita orang buat lah benda tu. Tapi at the same time, saya mengaku saya tengah bergaduh dengan Bang Fee juga sikit. Alam-alam muda kan, macam biasa lah tu. But after that, we got back and no problem. Jalan balik.
Dia macam gaduh sikit and then rindu lah.
Yes, it's meant to be. Benda tu meant to be. Sebab same time, Ascenders pun, we went on, ada show juga. Tapi at the same time, macam lah, Bang Fee kena jalan juga ni. Patutnya idea jalan dua-dua. It's just a project kan, so dua-dua kena jalan. Tapi when Ascenders jalan, macam Bang Fee was a bit, saya masih macam tak okay lah. So that's why kita orang buat balik Bang Fee tu betul. And Ascenders maybe akan coming soon kot.
Oh really? Yeah,
we never know.
Okay.
We never know. Benda tu, we never know.
But because it was never officially released, right? It's just single, right?
You guys never... Ascenders?
Yeah.
Yes, tak ada album, no nothing we didn't release, but we have singles lah. I think three kot.
Your top three local punya albums?
Yang aku dengar lah.
Yang kau dengar lah.
Yeah, that's matter. Disagree, One Mark Shot dengan Prana, I think. I had a CD. Tapi, like I said lah, macam they inspired me tapi I didn't really study, faham tak? Because time tu we was too busy with Green Day Sum 41. So but the apa, the local scene, it gave me that semangat yang macam, wow, we can do it here. Itu yang penting sebenarnya zaman tu. Zaman kita orang naik tu zaman yang sangat-sangat perfect to do music.
The best show yang korang pernah perform?
The best show, I think it was MTV World Stage lah bro. I think because that was the biggest crowd. Selalunya the biggest crowd, kita dapat a different vibe kan. Different loudness to it. So, there was Katy Perry and then all these international kan. So, Sam rasa macam, I'm really representing Malaysia ni bro. Itu, that's my vibe. I like those kind of semangat thing. Macam, okay, let's do it properly. That was one of the best show, yeah.
This thing orang selalu cakap macam, oh, the vibe yang audience bagi tu, dia lain macam punya tu.
Betul. I mean, bro, I tell you, it's addictive.
Really?
Serious bro. The first time I rasa kita orang, we got a feedback orang nyanyi balik lagu tu macam, weh, terus we have to do some more songs. And then benda tu lama-lama, I think it's entertainment je lah kan. We're on stage and then the crowd has to be loud. Diorang kena juga bagi balik apa yang kita bagi on stage. Baru jadi show tu.
Lepas ni kita akan biasa mengorek all the physical releases yang ada. Kita tengok apa yang dia nak pilih.
Expedisi. Style. Wet. Heard of that one.
Kau sebab zaman kaset, Sam?
Zaman kaset, yes bro. Sebab time beli, aku cakap Ibu Raihan tu kaset lah kan. And then my sister gila boy band bro. Ini familiar. Hanson. Ini sangat familiar bro. When I was small memang yang banyak go, gila music pop boy band ni my sister pasang into my ears tau.
Masa tu apa benda, what was the impression it left?
I have pop lah. Faham tak? That's why some people kan bila dia tak dengar pop sangat, bila dia dengar contoh dia terus jump into punk, dia akan tepu bro. They will have that punk. Memang macam okay this. But because of this juga, so that's why I say ada melodic kot. Like Backstreet Boys, stuff like that. Yes, serious.
Menari
bro.
Ya?
Ha?
Menari ya?
Eh, menari tidak. Menari tidak.
Oh, bukan macam Lock. Lock menari weh.
Lock menari ya?
Dia point to see. Saya pakai CD.
Saya menari to Michael Jackson, yes. Kecil-kecil saya menari Michael Jackson. Bro, aku ada semua yang apa? The
glove.
The glove. Aku ada topi. Dia ada jual set dulu.
Ya,
yeah, bro. Memang gila. Ow! That was me.
Menari
sikit lah. Macam, you know, kena ada sikit, kena balance. Punk section, saya mendengar The Clash, Sex Pistols, Blink 182. Blink 182, not this one. I think it's this album, which has Damn It in it. Yep. Okay, Blink influenced me on attitude. They really gave me, sebab diorang keluar dengan lagu macam bogeylah, apalah, macam it's a different punk tau. Time tu kita orang culture shock, apa diorang buat ni? Kita orang pun kadang-kadang macam tu juga. So, ini impact, yes. And bands like Yellow Card, Good Charlotte, impact. Dari segi lirik, dari segi apa, sebab diorang ceritakan benda-benda yang lebih kurang. With My Life, Good Charlotte.
Kalau ada one song from Good Charlotte yang kau cakap, okay, kalau kau minat Bang Fizz, you need to listen to this song. What would that song be?
Good Charlotte, Hold On. Dia macam satu lagu yang a bit down lah. You're down and you listen to that song. That helped me. That saved my life. Green Day. Green Day pun banyak influence kita orang dari segi performance. Performance and also the vibe. So macam Sam ambil all these bands kan. Macam dia ada ni, dia ada ni, dia ada ni. Pop! Let's do something. Ini aku kenal. Ni kalau kau nak tahu, sebuah ska band, Skudap Skudip. Sama sekolah dengan kita orang, okey? Dot memang senior kita orang. Dia lah yang dia kalau kat sekolah tu, dia seorang je ada gitar. Kalau macam ada kantin, dia seorang menyanyi lah, apalah. Dia try to fight the system. Cikgu-cikgu semua tak bagi kan. Skudip-skudip yang buat. So, diorang memang agak punk juga and style.
Kelang punya scene macam mana masa tu?
Banyak juga band daripada Kelang, like Zipzilla. Banyak band juga. Dan kita orang ada satu tempat tu, Tune Studio, dulu kat Kelang. Kita orang akan jamming kat situ. Concord, oh itu satu tempat yang lama kalau orang Kelang. Dia Concord Studio. Owner dia Jackie. Mesti orang mesti kenal punya. Dia ada dia ada satu studio tu RM13 je bro sejam.
Ya. Yeah.
Yes, tapi dia punya simbol atas kayu je. Satu kayu dia sangkut dua ah keng 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 lah kau.
Ya. Yeah.
Yeah. Kita orang tak ada duit, kita orang akan naik bas sampai dekat bus stand Kelang dan jalan all the way nak dekat sampai Kelang Perit. Adalah 5 kilo jalan just to jamming. Those were the days. OEG definitely impact Bang Fizz juga, especially 60s TV. Sebab diorang dulu kan, time ada scene dulu di mana kita orang tak masuk pun lagi. Band-band ni lah yang kat situ, Disagree, OEG, The Times. So we have to respect all of the work they've done for Malaysia, bro. Kau tak ada scene kan?
Betul.
Tak ada yang sebelum, tak ada yang selepas.
Betul.
Beatles, The Beatles was in my house. My mum play sangat-sangat. Even though macam kita orang besar dekat, yalah 5 tahun dekat UK dulu, so sempatlah kita orang go through TV, apa, English TV shows tau. Even in the comedy movies that we watch pun, lagu-lagu Beatles juga yang memang selalu ada.
You mentioned earlier tadi, your dad banyak dengan 60-an. He's a big music fan ke macam mana?
Dia bukan big music fan, tapi I think itu era dia lah. Dia memang penggemar Aram Lee, Jeffrey Dean, ramai lagi sebenarnya. So every time kalau kita orang pergi Morib kan, kecil-kecil dia bawa pergi Morib lah. Lagu tu lah kau dengar sejam. So itu pasal ada sekali satu lagu tu kita orang featuring Jeffrey Dean.
Okay, macam
apa pun tak boleh. Lagu tu. That was the main idea. Dan saya memang nak my dad jumpa Jeffrey Dean. Tapi tak sempat je lah. Sebab dia very busy guy. No effects. Impact music kita orang juga. Because of the lyrics pun very political. Kan? Zaman tu memang as a teenager kita suka lah benda-benda macam ni kan. Everyone is talking about love song. Tiba-tiba diorang ni is going about this, we don't like that man, we want it to be like this. This is how it's supposed to be, society and stuff like that. So itu NOFX beri impact yang sangat besar. Pak An suka NOFX. Pak An banyak dengar NOFX.
So dia punya riffing apa semua tu?
Yes, we took that.
Yep, inilah hasil korekan Sam dekat Teenage Hits Records. Hanson, WJ, Skurat Skudip, Bling One. Bling, dia sebenarnya Bling 182 ke Bling 182?
Bling 182.
182 eh?
Rasanya lah.
Rasanya. Kau pun tak sure. Anyway, Sam, thanks a lot for your time.
No problem, bro. Thank you for having me.
So, till the next episode, ciao.